Hello everyone, it's Kent here. Welcome to a new reaction video. This is the top 10 games of the Xbox and Bethesda showcase of 2022. Number 10.
See, I've taste.
We brought updates that were free to those who sailed the sea, though there's always more potential within. And as this song will spell out, there's plenty to sing about. Now that you can finally be a
already captain of our ship.
Can you imagine owning your own ship?
Save ship loadouts.
Oh
my god, finally! You can customize inside. Holy shit.
Name your own ship!
You can name your ship! It took 5 years! 5 years to get text in the game. Yes. Yes.
How does we have both game beats?
We gotta figure out something. And it's available with Xbox Game Pass, of course. Oh, to set sail as a pirate captain, adventure will come knocking on your
door. Oh, to set sail as a pirate captain. Oh, nice. And you'll be amazed at what we have in store. Cash in points,
okay.
Captain your own ship. Find it. In season 7 to see
your thieves. Next season.
Season 7. July 21st.
Nice. Number 9.
Mafia.
Oh, Mafia. Buzzard.
Hello? Four? Anyone here?
Never mind.
Benedict. Oh my god, it reminds me of The Darkness. Oh, so good games on Xbox. My best shadow guy.
Since I found the first piece, there must be more. That's him. My father.
I can guide you through his memories.
I like how this one looks. I played a few 2D games on stream, like Little Nightmares and
pull yourself together, Benedict.
The Last Case of Benedict Fox. Yeah, I'll definitely remember that in next year. Number 8.
Finally, your boat will be your special boat. Personal boat.
I like that you can say loadouts because there's a lot of like things to choose.
Yeah. How many loadouts boats do you have to talk? Face?
I hope they at least have like 10, 15.
Yeah. Welcome back, Chris.
Think your daughter will like this? I think it looks cool, the art style and stuff.
I will not.
Cool title, cool like picture.
2023.
Number 7.
Oh, this game looks familiar.
Yeah, I've seen this before too. Is it a Hollow Knight or something?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yes, he for me.
I think it's Hollow Knight. They're pretty good, the 2D games.
Yeah. I'm not so interested.
I haven't played it, but... Yeah, for me, I have to, it has to be co-op if I'm gonna play these games. It's fun if it's co-op. It looks good though.
Yeah.
Little boss fights and shit. Hollow Knight Silk Song. Oh, that's also Game Pass. I didn't know Xbox owned that series. Number 6.
Okay.
What's up with all these severed heads?
Why Japan always getting attacked? It's either
Japan,
right? Or United States.
Team Ninja. It's in Nio 3. This is Ninja Gaiden, right? No. It's probably Nio because they're doing so well with those games. Only games they make I know is Ninja Gaiden and the Nio games. So much effects, so pixelated.
Yeah. Are you watching it still on Twitch?
Yeah.
Wulong.
Wulong. Wait, it's a new IP. Okay. Feel like a hack and slash. I'm down. Early 23. Number 5.
I've seen the movement in the dark. I've seen the shadow. I see it.
Oh Lord!
Yeah, I think it is Red Foil. It looks like a vampire.
Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God.
Dang. That doesn't die.
Oh shit, there's more! I got you!
This person can't aim. Yeah. They're okay with the flare gun.
Kiss your ass goodbye.
Jacob! Oh, thank God.
Man, come it's on, pixelated on the stream. When, like, action happens.
You know, Redfall used to look like it was straight out of a postcard.
On Discord.
A picturesque island off the coast of Massachusetts.
I can see squares, actual
the bustling
squares.
Historic downtown.
I miss much when I just started the Grix.
And the old lighthouse.
Hi, Grix.
Is it like open world?
Something
like a big area.
People started vanishing, and those who didn't sold out big time. Fast forward, basically everyone's either a vampire, a cultist trying to become a vampire, or dead. And these aren't just trashy movie vampires. These monsters blocked out the sun and pushed back all the water, totally cut us off from the outside world.
Oh.
Gotta admit though,
yeah.
If I have to be stuck on an island full of vampires, I'm glad it's with y'all.
Feelings mutual. Yes.
Aw, thanks, Jacob. We've also got Remy, our engineer genius, and her little robot.
Open Twitch.tv Xbox if you want to.
Yeah, I
do. Who's the good robot? Who's the best robot?
And our resident expert on all things creepy.
I prefer the term cryptozoologist, you know.
To each their own.
Last but not least, yours truly. I
robot
have these weird powers.
Yeah, powers.
We've been digging for answers but haven't found much beyond blood.
I think it looks
death.
Better than the.
Luckily, the vampires and their sycophants
Back
aren't discreet about where they like to nest. I'd bet the answers we need are inside those tourist traps turned fortresses.
Spotted some bloodsuckers in their fan club near the festival grounds. Let's start there. Ghosting out.
Cultists could go straight at him or just slip past.
Let's just get this done. On my mark.
Yeah, it's like Left 4 Dead Vampire.
Oh shit, blood bags! I know we're here. Look alive!
This one is mine.
Going up!
Cool. That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
But I thought he was gonna like stand on it, like he built a tower. I was about to say like, this is like some Fortnite stuff, but my first time, okay.
My cryptid hunter's intuition tells me there's a nest nearby.
Your what?
Dev, that's not a thing.
Found something.
Oh, now I simply must go in there.
What is that? Where does it go?
Turn down a little bit. And I think I need to
some kind of collective consciousness. That's impossible.
I might have to open this on YouTube.
There's
YouTube
the movie
stream,
theater. I used to come here all the time. Why do they have to mess this up for me? Ah, shit.
It's alive. It'll collapse any second.
Run!
It's Red Hawk.
All of little grannies want to sip their tea. Feel free. But it looks like the weapons have like rarity, you know, blue and stuff. This trailer has been pretty long, I feel like. It comes to PC Game Pass and the Xbox Game Pass, nice. Number 4. Console launch exclusive.
Selling humans is drugs. You're the only one that can stop them.
What the heck?
Realize we're gonna have to take out the entire alien drug cartel.
It sounds like Morty.
Oh, it's from the creators of Rick and Morty.
You're gonna leave me here in what, space?
Everybody lives in space, including you. All right, you're a bounty hunter now. You've got to help me rescue my friends. They're Gatlians, just like me.
Cyberpunk.
Cyberpunk.
Hey, Cyberpunk, you have a gun tight that talks too.
Dinner first and some bubble bath maybe first.
Look at us, blasting away.
We're sweet.
Oh yeah, that's one of my children. They die fast. Don't worry, it's easy to make more.
The guns look cool. It's like funny. Oh.
Hey there.
What a knife, dude.
Hey there.
Yes, more. I need more stabbing.
Everyone, fight each other.
Looks like they're freaking Care Bears.
Yeah.
That's pretty interesting looking. Like,
okay, well now I sorta, now I can.
Game Pass?
October. Alright. Yes, that's Game Pass there. Oh, cool. Okay.
Number 3.
I'm sorry, Amicia.
I was gonna say, I didn't show Callisto again. Because he was the focus
of the yet.
It's a Plague Tale?
Yeah, looks like it.
Plague Tale 2? Rat Jam?
The macula's not just in Hugo's blood. It concerns everyone. And it can change everything.
I think I watch Forge play through the whole of this game, and then I watch you rage quit when you die to the rat. I try to turn off the light.
You still remember that?
Yeah.
Damn it.
Oh, you still got turn off lights or turn on lights in this, so.
Look out! There's a killer around here! One of our men has been murdered!
I feel like this, I gotta just gotta say, I don't know if it's the stream, but this, the quality on this game was kind of bad.
Yeah.
I think it's like washed out.
You're only making it worse!
Yeah.
Amicia, don't! I'm tired of being afraid. I'll show them that it's over.
Finally.
Was the kid that had powers, or was it her? I'm not sure. Was it the kid?
You are not them. What is wrong with me? Hugo.
Amicia. That's pretty good though. Oh yeah, he was about to boom. Oh, it's coming this year, actually. Okay. No date, though. But, number two. That's not creepy.
I speak now to those who heed a darker
call. Is that a werewolf or what?
Those bold enough to cross the line.
Is that that the one game?
For deeper knowledge.
What's it called again?
Who follow an
unquenchable Shadow and Bone
yearning,
or something?
Born of blood and bone.
You said bone, right when you said it.
To unlock the forbidden secrets.
That game is out already, though. If it is that game.
Rituals. Calling for life.
I remember Ubisoft making death. was making a book game.
My family. My
son. Jeez.
To truly embrace this power, you must take it into the world.
It was a show called Shadow Legacy or something. It was it looked like a Robin Hood kind of game. But it ended up being like a co-op
marked
for multiplayer.
Sacrifice to this profane knowledge.
It could be something else.
Yeah.
This looks more single player.
You will be a priest of Rathma. A necromancer. And you will not confront the darkness alone.
Why do you have your hair in your face? Like, you could see better if you didn't.
And the dead have no mercy.
Hello, Chris. It's Diablo. What? Diablo 4. I didn't even think that was Diablo at all. Holy shit. New class Necromancer.
I'm very excited to
it didn't
announce
even look
our fifth
like...
and final class, the Necromancer.
Wait, this is the Gears
of
War guy.
Who joins the other
what the hell are you doing on Diablo?
Around the campfire in Diablo 4. These include the mighty barbarian, the elemental sorcerer, the crafty rogue, and the powerful druid. And you'll want them because the demon Lilith, the daughter of hatred, has returned and spreading corruption and evil as she fights to reclaim our dark gothic world as her own. And it's
Diablo
up to
hype.
You to stop her. Now, Diablo 4 is the culmination of the 25-year history of the franchise, building on top of the best of what's come before with some, you know, unique twists all its own. So let's dig a little deeper by watching, for the first time I might add,
gameplay?
Some Xbox Series X gameplay.
Ooh.
While hearing from a few of the many people behind the game.
Are you playing this, Enos? Diablo 4? Have you played them before?
Diablo 4 is the next generation of action RPG, melding monster slaying and loot collecting with a fully realized open world.
I don't think so.
It's not for the faint of heart.
Oh, you don't like this,
it's gory
this game?
And unnerving.
It's not one of my,
it's creepy. You know.
Diablo 4 is all about player choice.
All
the pillars of a Diablo game and just expands them with all the new features that people really love and appreciate in modern games. Whoever you see yourself being, you can create in Diablo 4.
Character customization.
It's important to include robust character customization because then I can play the fantasy that I want to play.
I think they have that in 3 as well. When I play that a little bit.
It allows you to switch around your playstyle as well.
Everything feels very powerful and fun.
This is awesome.
One of the really cool things about having an open world is your journey that you take throughout Diablo 4 is your own. There's no linear path that you have to follow.
We've got almost 150 dungeons in the game.
Damn.
There's all kinds of surprises as you're exploring.
Strongholds are an enemy territory that you need to reclaim.
But you might have a space that begins as
yeah,
a
Diablo
area,
is like the most popular
after you've cleared it out.
The evil in this place
when it comes to these
cleansed.
Games.
It now becomes a friendly town.
Sometimes it's a new town, sometimes it's a new dungeon. There's
you
a
like
whole
Diablo
bunch of rewards that you get. And you have a real impact on the world.
Okay, everyone do beside you.
No, you can't leave us here. They might come back any moment.
Local events are really cool little story
like
segments that happen within
the open
world
story games.
You'll just be running through a world, and then a local event will pop up, and you can choose to participate in it, or get a group together and just wail on these like giant world bosses.
These are events that take a lot of people.
That's why we
really
plays really good
together.
On console. This. They specifically talked about Series X for this game.
Being able to see all the players on your screen collaborating, trying to take this big monster down. It's
worked on console.
It's so easy to create a community. It makes Diablo more of a social experience.
We've got fully enabled crossplay.
If you have an Xbox
crossplay?
And everybody
nice.
Has a PC, you're going to be able to group up.
Or you could play couch co-op. Two people on a couch can sit there and have a great experience.
Local co-op, always nice to have, even though nobody do
We've
it anymore.
We've created specific zones where players can engage in PvP.
If you go there, you can
yeah,
start
I don't
swinging
do PvP.
Away at people. But you're also opening yourself up to being swung at.
If you're like really, really good, the game actually marks you as like a champion on the map.
If he's stuff, I will turn off.
And everyone wants to chase you down.
The last story mission is really the beginning of a whole different part of the journey.
Now you're set up for the end game, and that end game is rich with things to do that allow you to get more and more powerful.
Whether it's new items or new dungeons or new paragon boards, every single time you come back to play Diablo 4, there's going to be new stuff for you to experience.
And it's something that we're going to support for years to come.
Cool, cool.
I'm really excited for folks to get their hands on Diablo
yeah.
4.
Just to see millions of people really enjoying the different options.
Through the campaign,
local events,
couch co-op,
endgame,
PvP, it almost doesn't end.
And we are so close.
They're going to give a release date because they're so close.
I'm
I would guess January is my guess.
October.
October next year? Oof.
Oh, 2023.
Number one.
Ready to start on your signal.
And besides Elder Scrolls, this is like one of the most hyped games, I think, of all time. I'm afraid of this looking bad now.
Coordinates input. Plotting jump course. Guidance is converged. We're looking good.
Please tell me this is good.
System checks are green across the board. Grav jump commencing in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
If that was it, then
It's hard to express how excited all of us at Bethesda are to be here with you today. We're so grateful you're spending the time, and we know you've waited a long time to finally see Starfield. It's easily our most ambitious game ever. Like our previous games, it's an epic role-playing game where you get to be who you want and go where you want. But this time, you'll be exploring space. So let's jump right in. This is early in the game as you arrive on the mysterious moon of Crete.
I mean, they are gods of RPGs, so it has the potential to be like so good.
Yeah.
This looks good. I wonder if they use a new engine, or if this is the same Skyrim engine that they will not go away from ever. The smoke effects are laggy.
Yeah.
It's the Skyrim engine.
I can't already tell you.
According to the scanners, the abandoned research facility is in this direction.
They're like these cool little creatures and stuff, like Fallout. Like, yeah, they all have that. You can do that in Fallout too. They've never done third person good though. They always looked kind of weird, like in Fallout and Skyrim.
Yeah.
Maybe they're showing it off. Like crab aliens. I hope they were gonna show third person a little more, see if it was any better. Oh, that is very No Man's Sky.
Yeah.
And fleet are using the facility.
That looks like a P90. I don't trust they have as resource collection. I mean, like, it's blurry.
That they don't really, you know, collect the resources on traders. They just want it to, and then that's it.
I don't even want to collect resources like that. I wanted to fight things like this. That's why you're doing Bethesda games. You know, you fight things and don't really care about getting materials like from the planet in RPG. That's a looting.
You're gonna pay for that.
The third person gameplay. See, there wasn't like even a crosshair in third person, you can't see where you're aiming.
After some initial encounters, you're invited to join Constellation, who, in the future the game is set in, are the last group of space explorers. To meet them, you'll head to the capital city of New Atlantis.
This
game hasn't really, at the moment, hasn't taken my...
This place looks cool, though. This looks like a very Fallout-y city, like a lot of life, and... I'm just afraid it will be too empty, like, if you're traveling space. That's the problem with No Man's Sky, there's, like, nothing in the actual game, you know?
Yeah.
If this is story-driven, then sure.
The graphic looks good on the
piece.
Yeah? We're all here because we're committed to the biggest question.
The Bethesda RPGs, you know, it's the interaction and doing missions, right?
These artifacts could be.
It has to be story driven.
As to what they are,
like most Fallout and Skyrim missions are.
You'll be part of solving that puzzle.
Interactive. Like,
The faces look good.
You found something?
The new guy found it.
You dug up the artifact, right? That means you.
I mean, they're showing that now, the interactions and stuff. So it seems like they still, they have that.
The artifact you found appears to be one of many scattered across the galaxy.
Oh, this looks pretty good.
We can unlock the secrets.
They should have showed this first before they showed that whole gameplay thing.
Told me that it spoke.
Maybe like some galaxies are like empty. You just go there and find, let's say a fire. I'm just trying out there.
Yeah. I could do a mission on the planet and come back.
Yes.
And
to work and then just together, more missions around these cities.
This stuff looks cool.
We're not just here to shoot the bad guys. We're peacekeepers. We
hopefully you have choices on what to say.
When you sign up with the Crimson Fleet, no one quits. The only way out.
I think it's on Fallout you can choose.
Death.
What to say?
The path ahead may be dangerous.
Yeah, you can do that forward.
But we are not stopping.
Hopefully it has that choice,
Most Dusties don't even make it this far.
Yeah, I like this stuff.
Because whatever
very
lies at
story.
The end of this road,
and stuff.
Oh, it's just like my interest.
Forever.
Play day one on PC Game Pass.
That gives you a look at the stories in Starfield. But ultimately, it's not our
why
story.
Is he so low
it's
compared
the story
to the
you
trailer?
Create by who you are and the choices you make. And that starts with character creation.
Oh, nice.
Oh, they're showing the creation. Okay.
It's our most flexible yet. You can customize all the elements of how you look.
But is it better than WWE?
Most likely.
You'll pick a background that gives you 3 starting skills.
I mean, I don't mind it being simple, as long as you can do some stuff.
Having a way with words might prove useful.
There are optional traits, and these come with unique advantages and disadvantages.
You should be able to mod most games.
I think most Bethesda games you can.
But it's not just in how you can look. And how your character plays and develops.
Like to have
the skill system combines the best from our previous games, and you can unlock new skills as you level up, and then you rank those skills up by using them
trees,
and completing challenges.
Physical, social, combat.
And there's deep crafting systems, from running research projects with resources you find, to crafting weapon mods needed to survive.
Yeah, space of the Joker. I bet you can.
And you can build your own outposts.
If there's money.
These act as a home away from home for survival and resource generation. You can choose where and how
building
to
looks
build
good.
Each one.
Yeah.
And
implement
you can hire characters
forward.
You meet to keep it up and running.
It's kind of hard to make
but
a house in Fallout 4.
That's not all. You can even build your own spaceships.
Oh, nice. But you can build your actual own spaceship and everything in there. That's interesting.
You can choose crew members.
Ooh,
and yes,
really
you can completely customize the look and layout.
Damn, okay, that's pretty sick.
Yeah.
There's loads of different modules, ship manufacturers, and more. I have to say, it's so cool, we just absolutely love
that's
this.
That's awesome. Yeah.
It's not just how the ship looks.
And then you try to go inside, and it's like
from
full of boxes
to shields
inside.
To weapon systems, because yes, you can fly it.
You can't get it. You can fly it? Yeah, no, if you can make your ship, you can fly it? What would be the point? What do you mean you can fly it? It's a spaceship. The fuck?
How can you make a spaceship but you can't fly? It's just there.
It's below a spaceship and it's just chilling. The planet looks fucking realistic, holy.
I wonder if there's
hyperspeed! Space battle!
Star Wars! Never
space looks better than the No Man's Sky.
Yeah.
It wasn't bad in that game either, but. Everything besides like the start of like him going down to that little station, that's been pretty good.
Yep.
They could've just skipped the whole part. And show this.
Costas, take your flat earth group.
Our planet's flat.
I can't wait for all of you to experience the game. Thanks again for being with us today, and thanks for all the support you've given us over the decades, especially on this game. It's been an incredible journey for us making it, but we know that's really only the beginning, for it's when all of you play it that the real journey begins. And you may be wondering, just how big is this game? So we thought we'd take one last moment and show you.
All right.
Let's take a look at one of our planets, Jemison. You can land in New Atlantis, but you can also land and explore anywhere on the planet.
Yep.
And it's not just this planet. It's all the planets in the system.
Even the sun?
From barren but resource-heavy ice balls to Goldilocks planets.
Yeah, go into the sun and see what happens.
And not just this system.
That spaceship you used 4 hours on.
Over 1,000
look real nice after.
All open for you to explore. We can't wait
hey, show the sun after
to see what you find.
Earth-like planets.
So like that's the hubs that has like all the people you talk to, and then I guess missions will just be put randomly around on the planets and stuff.
Dinosaurs.
It's promising. I think the planets will be like No Man's Sky, Chris, where you're, it's of course smaller than a real planet, but you can like fly straight to different areas.
Same here, Chris.
But yeah, it looks good. Next year, you got delayed.
Year.
Everything is next year.
Damn it. Hey, Game Pass. Late day one. Never mind.
I think I'll play it on Xbox because this will be so tanky on PC. Streaming.
I will play it on PC.
So this was probably the best of the show, which is... It kind of had to be. So that's the top 10 games and game announcements for the Xbox and Bethesda showcase. Of course, these are my opinions. I didn't include Forza Motorsport, which I'm not really that fan of. I think these 10 games stood out the most. If you don't agree with me, you could better comment what you think it was cooler. Thanks for watching this video. I'm Kenneth signing out.